Hi friends, we can go for the next video lecture. Here we can observe what is how to save the file and how to create a working directory for the R console. Here in a C drive, see where is C drive? We can find out in the my computer. Here drives are seen in this. This is the Windows drive. Here R is installed. Open the C drive. Here we have to create a working directory for the R program. Here R trial is a working directory created for this. It consists some data already. Here I will save the data. Now open the data first. Here we can see this is the data we just typed. Here, I will save this file. Click on save. Open the C drive. Open the C drive and R trial. Here, I save the file like height weight. I save the file like height weight. The file type is R data. In the R data format, I save it. Okay, now I will try to import one data from Excel. This is the data I want to import. This is I will explain the structure of this data. See, it consists of several questions gender, management, locale, subject and occupation are coded here. Then question 1 to 8 for knowledge, question 9 to 16 for performance, so question 17 to 24 for personal abilities, question number 25 to 32 for social abilities, question number 33 to 39 and 40 for technical abilities, 41 to 48 for management. Okay, and then this is the total of these dimensions, that is teaching competency, and this is intelligence. These are the main two variables, teaching competency and intelligence. The dimensions of teaching competencies, management, technical, etc. And the items are scales, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And we can conduct item analysis, ANOVA, etc. using this data. I will try to explain this analysis using this data. For that we have to import this data here. To import the data, click on this file, open document. This is one way. There may be some other ways are also there to open data. Here this open data is there. In this way we can import. Okay, I try to import data here. Click on desktop. The file is saved. Here all file format, instead of all file format, we have to find out Excel data. Then only we can add the data here. For that, importing Excel file, maybe some plugin may be needed if it is used for first time. Okay, we can observe whether it is needed or not. If it is needed, we have to download it. For that we can always keep it the internet connected. Then only we can add such files here. I will demonstrate. Please wait. ഈ എക്സ്പോർട്ട് എക്സ്പ്ലെയിൻ ചെയ്ത ഈ എക്സൽ ഷീറ്റ് എങ്ങനെയാണ് ആറിലേക്ക് ഇമ്പോർട്ട് ചെയ്യുക എന്നുള്ളതാണ് ഞാൻ പറയാൻ ഉദ്ദേശിച്ചത്. ഇവിടെ നമുക്ക് നോക്കാം. ഈ ഓപ്പൺ എന്ന് പറയുന്ന ഈ ഐക്കൺ ക്ലിക്ക് ചെയ്യുക. അതിനുശേഷം ഡെസ്ക്ടോപ്പിൽ ഡാറ്റ ഷീറ്റ്, ഇതായിരുന്നു നമ്മുടെ ഫയൽ, ഈ ഡാറ്റ ഷീറ്റിൽ ക്ലിക്ക് ചെയ്യുക. ക്ലിക്ക് ഓപ്പൺ. ഓപ്പൺ ചെയ്യുമ്പോൾ ഏത് ഷീറ്റാണ് ലോഡ് ചെയ്യേണ്ടതെന്ന് ചോദിക്കും. വിച്ച് ഡാറ്റ ഷീറ്റ് ടു ബി ഓപ്പൺഡ്, ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് മെൻഷൻഡ് ആസ് 1. ഓക്കെ. Then wait for loading this data. Okay, now it is being loaded. And we have to observe whether it is appeared here. Here we can see that data sheet. Click on that. Now that Excel sheet is appeared here. See? Okay. And in this data sheet, we can work for the further analysis like item analysis and all other things. Here variable view is the here data view is the. Okay, now we can conduct we can conduct item analysis. I think that is good. I think for that click here, then click for click on psych. Click on psych reliability analysis. Click on reliability and select the questions and put it here. Select only the questions for analysis. Add all questions here. Okay, now all questions are added here. Any other things are the just remove it. Okay, all items are now added there and click on run. It will run the things here. From that values we can identify the cronbach alpha value. Here the row alpha value is 0.92 and the standard alpha value is 0.94. From this, it is clear that the item, the scale is highly reliable, and we can assure how much it is reliable is that as a thumb rule, it is best to select items with more than the value of 0.75. Some others, textbook others said that 0.6 and above is also good, but it will make an error of 40%, 0.6 means. So it is better to take 0.75 and above alpha value. And then here some more explanations are here. Here is a heading, reliability if an item is dropped. That is, if you remove any item, how much the value will increase. We can observe it from here. This table is continued. The next part of the table is continued here, and the last part is here. Here R drop value is there. From the R drop value, find out any item which will increase the alpha value. I think there is no value which will increase, no value which will increase the alpha value, because all the values are less than the obtained value. So if you remove any item, it will decrease. Okay, it will decrease the alpha. So it is better to keep all the items. In that way, we can find out whether any item is less associated, less correlated with the whole scale. If such items are present, we can remove such items from the tool. Okay, now reliability analysis is conducted by clicking psych and reliability. It will give only one value, that is very equivalent to Cronbach alpha. Okay, thank you for watching.